Jupiter is nothing but how much the soul is aware in this world. So the more Jupiter is greater in dignity, the greater awareness the soul has.
True.
The soul is very aware of everything, you know. Mm-hmm. Soul is aware. Okay, somebody is dying.
Yeah.
I feel pain for that person, even if I don't know that person. That will not come from Sun, Mars.
That will come from Jupiter, like empathy.
Yeah, awareness basically.
Mm-hmm.
I am a student, I should study. That's awareness, right? You are aware that you should be studying and not just partying all the time.
True.
You are going to a guru, that means you have to be submissive and you have to listen to what he says. Tad vidhi pranipate na pariprasne na sevaya. So the soul is aware that, aware of how it, how he should behave.
Mm-hmm.
And that is why the word which is used in scriptures for the soul, which is for, not for the soul, for Jupiter, is dhi. Dhi is intelligence. And in Srimad Bhagavatam, there's the verse, you know, Satyam Param Dhimahi. That Dhimahi means the one who is the greatest level of intelligence is one who is aware of Param Satya, God. So that means the soul is completely aware that I am a servant of God. I am his part and parcel. That's the highest level of awareness.
Mm-hmm.
You can be aware that a scorpion is hitting me. Or there is a sound and your sleep breaks. It's all awareness, you see. But the highest form of awareness is Satyam Param Dhimahi, that I am a spirit soul, I am a servant of God. The more I serve God, the more I'll be happier. That's what Jupiter represents. That is why Jupiter is the significator of spirituality. Because it shows your awareness of this world, which ultimately culminates in God. So when you say somebody's Jupiter is great, it is exalted, it is in Mool Trikon, it's in own sign or whatever you want to say. Or when you say that this person has a strong Jupiter, what inherently it means? It means that the Atma of that person, or it's not Atma of that person, because that person itself is the Atma.
Mm-hmm.
That person, that Atma is highly aware.
True.
Without that, there is nothing in this world. People are just moving like a bunch of robots. There's no life. It is the Kalaka for life.
True.
That is why they say that when Jupiter aspects the fifth or transits the fifth, then there can be a birth of children. Why? Because it is giving some life there.
True.
Why they say that Jupiter, whenever aspects the seventh or transits the seventh, like I was talking to one of my friend. She was telling about a girl who is a Taurus ascendant, and she got married. Why? Because now Jupiter is transiting in her seventh house in Scorpio.
It's throwing light there.
Yeah. What do you mean when you say he's throwing light? You will just say, oh, he's throwing light. What throwing light? Throwing light means he's making you aware of that house. He's, whenever Jupiter aspects the seventh house, why do people say that they get married or they feel like getting married? Because now you become aware that, oh, maybe I should also find somebody. That's the only thing which is happening. Nothing else is happening. You are becoming more aware that I am not having a partner. I should find, or I should try to get married. If you want to provide it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just a level of awareness. So that is why whenever you talk of ascendant, you must see this planet.
True.
Otherwise you will just see, oh, Lagna Lord is in 10th house, like for Donald Trump. He's a Leo Lagna.
Mm-hmm.
His son is in Taurus. He's a Leo ascendant. So for Leo Lagna, Taurus is in the 10th house. So his Lagna Lord has gone to 10th house. Point number one. Point number two, it is in directional strength, because Sun gets directional strength in the 10th house. So you will say, wow, what a chart this is. Yes. And that, yeah, that's true in one way. He's the president of US. There's no doubt about it. Mm-hmm. But does it mean that he's a great personality? For that, we have to check Jupiter, where Jupiter is, what Jupiter is doing, what Jupiter is telling.
True.
Yes. Definitely. Recently, I met a person who has Jupiter in Ashwini Nakshatra in Aries. Mm-hmm. He is madly fascinated about cars for no reason. Because Ashwini is all about cars. Now you will say, oh, but his moon is somewhere else. Because generally they will say, right, wherever the moon is, you will be obsessed about those things. Or you will say, wherever Rahu is, you will be obsessed.
Yeah.
Yes. Wherever the Lagna Lord is placed, or if your ascendant nakshatra is Ashwini, will say, oh yeah, this person is very obsessed with cars, you know. Mm-hmm. But why is Jupiter in Ashwini giving him obsession about cars? Because the awareness is very high. Jupiter and Ashwini means whenever you see a car, you are totally aware. Oh my God, it's a car. You'll check the model. Oh, is it Mercedes, you know, CLA or the S series? BMW 3, 2, 5, 6, 7. Now the car is always there. Mm-hmm. And everybody else is also there. But you are the only person who is aware that this car is there.
True.
Otherwise, it's just another car, you know. Mm-hmm. So anyway, so these are the ways. So now, how do you measure the strength of the ascendant? And yes, of course, the ascendant also decides which planets rule which houses.
Yeah.
Why does the ascendant only do it? Why not the fifth house, 10th house?
Because that's how your chart is mapped, based on the ascendant. So then which planet rules which house? It's based on the ascendant.
Yeah, that's what my question is.
Yeah.
Because in the chart of Kalpurush, which is Aries, sun gets exalted there. Mm-hmm. The king is at its highest dignity there. So whatever the king says, everybody has to listen. Mm-hmm. Because he has made the rule. Now I am sitting here and you bunch of poor fellows, you will sit where I want. If I tell you that you will rule this house, you must rule it.
True.
This is not a sun in Leo or sun in Sagittarius. This is a sun in Aries. You must listen. Otherwise you're dead. You'll be persecuted by law.
Yeah.
And everybody follows the law in the higher cosmos. Mm-hmm. So that is why the ascendant is the place where the king sits. Mm-hmm. And that is why it is also the head.
True.
And that is why everybody thinks that I myself, I am the center of the universe.
True.
Everybody thinks that.
Yeah, sorry, go ahead.
Everybody thinks that this world is revolving around me only. Like there was one of my friend, I was in Chennai in 2010. Mm-hmm. So what used to happen was we stayed in staff quarters because we were a bit late. We didn't get hostel rooms. And the mm-hmm. girls' hostel was directly attached to the staff quarters like this. Mm-hmm. So whenever we will go out, and in staff quarters, only boys used to stay. Girls were not staying there. So whenever boys will go out of the staff quarters, they will always see girls. Okay. So one of my friend was there. I don't know his horoscope. But whenever he will go out, he will dress as if, my God, it's like the the world is going to come to an end if he does not dress. So one day I caught his neck and I asked him, hey, why do you waste 45 minutes to 2 hours just to dress? Mm-hmm. Why? What's the reason? If you don't dress, what is that will go wrong? Please tell me. And then my friend used to tell me that Don't you know that there are so many girls when I go out? They are all going to watch me when I go out. And nobody told him that how many girls are watching him. Or does anybody even watch him or not? But he has intrinsically assumed that everybody watches him. He's totally convinced that the girls will only watch one person, that is him. And it's not that he's obsessed that he's very handsome or anything like that. Mm-hmm. It is very natural for him to feel like this. And the funny thing is, everybody else also feels like this. Once I had attended a seminar long back, where one of my gurus, he was sitting and he was asked a question. A lady asked him a question, very beautiful question, beautiful answer he gave. She had asked him this question that, I am too much obsessed with thinking what people are thinking when they look at me. Like when I go to a party, it's good, bad. I'm too much obsessed with it. So how should I get rid of this obsession? These are all related to the lagna, the ascendant, you see, the body.
Yeah.
So then my Guru Maharaj, he answered that you will become detached from this problem if you know the fact that everybody is busy in watching how many people are watching them. So actually nobody is watching you. They are watching you to cross-check if you are watching them.
That's true, yeah.
So the moment you know this, you are detached because you know nobody is watching me.
That's true.
So why the body? Because the body is an expression for the soul at this material realm. So when you are conscious of how many are noticing you, what actually is happening? You are becoming conscious of the fact that Sun, Mars energy is working. Sun is like, okay, somebody is noticing you, and Mars is like the expression, the body. So that is why the lagna is very important, you see.
Yeah.
So any difficulties in the lagna can ruin the entire horoscope. And in ancient times in India, and even now it is there in some places, if you go, I will not take names. Mm-hmm. They will check, okay, you have this Raj Yoga, that Mahapurush Yoga, this, that, all placements are there. And then they will see, what's in the lagna. So then what they will do is, they will grade the horoscope, you know. Can you believe it?
Manually.
They will grade it. Okay, the ascendant is like this, A grade. Ascendant is like this, B grade.
Wow.
C grade, D grade, E grade. And when they grade like this, they will take all these three parameters into consideration, 3-4 planets. Mm-hmm. And by that they will decide how is the ascendant basically.
Sure.
And then they will look, okay, you want to know about marriage, what is there in the seventh house, let's have a look there now. But what do we do when we get a chart? You want to get married, wow, you have Venus in the seventh, fantastic, your married life will be right.
Seventh.
Oh my God, you have Saturn. Your married life is going to be miserable. Mm-hmm. But some said, you know, Saturn gets directional strength in the seventh house. So maybe it's not that bad. Saturn is good or bad for the seventh house. That's a separate issue. But the point which I'm making here is, we will only see the seventh house. Mm. But before you look at the seventh house, did you look at how he looks at the seventh house?
True.
You are going on looking at how the spouse is, or you take the Upapada and all those stuff you do, Gemini principles. Mm-hmm. But did you ever ask the person that what is your opinion of the seventh house? That you didn't do, that you didn't bother. Mm. Because you are just interested in finalizing which dasha he will get married, right?
True.
Then your job is done. Full marks. Yeah, the kind of astrology people do without the ascendant. It is like saying, like they used to say, no, operation is successful, but the patient is dead.
Yeah.
So we have successfully predicted. Like in Nadi, they say the 2nd, 7th and 11th houses, they deal with marriage. So let's take the example of a classic Leo ascendant. Mm-hmm. Why I'm taking Leo? Because for them it's a bit easy to explain. Because Mercury rules the 11th and 2nd.
Suppose
by any chance, by grace of God, Mercury is sitting in Aquarius for any Leo ascendant. Mm-hmm. And you go to any Nadi astrologer and be like, oh, Mercury Antadasa, congratulations. It's almost. Mm-hmm. Your own cards. But did you now definitely that planet will give you marriage? You have a good ascendant, you have a bad ascendant, you have a terrible ascendant, you have a fantastic ascendant. That dasha might give you marriage. All right. But the question is, what is your outlook about marriage? What is your outlook about career? 10th house. So suppose there is a malefic like Ketu or Saturn in the 10th. You will say, oh, you will have a very struggle will be there in career. Now you will have a lot of fights and it will be very slow. Your rise will be gradual. These are typical things you will find in YouTube. Just Google it. Saturn, Ketu in the 10th house. You will find all this. It's filled with all such stuff. But what if that person has Venus in the ascendant? Or that person has Jupiter in the ascendant?
Amazing.
Then what will happen is, whenever he's seeing for the 10th house, which is the house of career, he's always having a lens like this. So in the lens is the ascendant. So suppose there's a planet in the ascendant.